Krites Attack is the fifth film in the Krites franchise and features the Krites that terrorized movies in the 80s. This was a franchise that started in the 80s and went into the 90s and spawned four films about these little creatures that came to Earth and just killed a bunch of people. Eventually, the fourth film went to space. So many years after the fourth film, we get a fifth film straight to DVD called Krites Attack, which was directed by Bobby Miller. The original franchise was very campy, it was silly, and people considered a couple of them to be like the worst horror films ever. I don't have a strong connection to the Krites franchise. I actually watched the first film last week. But the new Krites Attack movie features Drea, who was just rejected from her college of choice. She lives with her little brother and her uncle. When an opportunity to become close to one of the mission board arises, Drea ends up becoming a babysitter for her children. While taking the two children and her brother for a walk in the park, they discover Bianca, Princess of the Krites, and the horror begins. I thought Krites Attack was okay. It wasn't very campy. At times it felt like it took itself a little too seriously, and it forgot all of the tones that were set up previously from the first four films. The first four films were very stupid, had some really bad performances, but there were films that you could watch and enjoy, you know, those campy horror films from the 80s. Krites was one of them. It's not a film that you were gonna take seriously and, you know, consider it to be the top of the list for horror films. Krites Attack seemed to forget what made those four films enjoyable. There were at times where the film did get a little bit campy and it was a little bit enjoyable, but I think that the overall tone and atmosphere that was created for Krites Attack was much more serious and more story-based than those previous other movies. Drea is played by Tashiana Washington, and she tries her hardest to make this movie funny. And I think that Washington tried a little too hard for it to be funny. A lot of her jokes and trying to disregard certain situations came off a little bit cringeworthy. The jokes did not land for me. It tried to be funny, but it definitely was trying too hard. Where the other Krites movies, the overall concept and situations and the acting was what made the movie funny. This was kind of a dull film, and the actors are trying to provide jokes for the movie, and they really just don't work. Also, many times in the movie, the writing tells us that Drea is a very smart person, but she's just not getting into that right college, the one college that she wants to go to because her mother had gone to that college. So many times throughout the movie, they tell us she's very smart. And then towards the end of the movie, when she's getting more involved with the Krites and she feels like she could, you know, kill them, they say to her, "Well, are you going to go back to college after this?" And she says college was never really for me, and she has a shotgun in her hand. That's implying that she wants to be like a bounty hunter, which bounty hunters did feature in the previous Krites movies, the first four films. So it's implying that she wants to become a bounty hunter, just like those previous characters. But there was no hint that she would be good at it previously in the movie, and now it just clicks to her that she wants to be a bounty hunter. It was very lazy writing. And speaking of bounty hunters, we did have a return from the original cast. Legendary horror actress Dee Wallace makes her return to the Krites franchise. This time around, she's not Helen Brown. Instead, she plays Aunt Dee. She is a bounty hunter, similar to other bounty hunters in the Krites franchise, and there's literally like no backstory for her at all. There's kind of a Sarah Connor feel to her character, but there's not enough time spent with her for you to actually care about her or explore her killer instincts or motivations. It just felt like a character returning and that was it, nothing more to it. This movie had all the right elements to work. It could have been cheesy. It brought back a character from the original franchise. It had practical effects. But B-horror cinema is supposed to have that cheesiness to it that you're supposed to like cringe and think, "Oh, this is really funny," and you want to watch it with your friends. Krites Attack is a movie that I probably would never watch again. It's not very cheesy, and at times it tries to take itself a little too seriously. The Krites are fun to watch once again, and there's a ridiculous scene involving a ton of Krites that I thought was ridiculous. And that's what I wanted most of the movie to be, was like that one scene of all these Krites together doing something really stupid, and I wanted to see that over again. But we just didn't get that, and it just missed the mark on what made the original franchise work so well. It tried to take itself too seriously. The jokes just came off very cringeworthy. They utilized a character from the previous movies, and they didn't really do much with her. Overall, I found Critters Attack to be pretty boring, not a fun time, and a very disappointing film. I'm gonna go ahead and give Critters Attack a C-. Thank you guys for checking my review for Critters Attack. Have you seen this fifth Critters film? If so, what'd you think about it? Stay tuned, I got a ranking video for all five of the Critters films. My name is JustinWatchesMovies, and you guys stay classy, YouTube.